Hello everyone! In this lesson, I will cover two of Integromat's most powerful inbuilt tools, Iterator and Array Aggregator. Let me begin by stating the purpose of each. The Iterator works only with an array and converts each collection of items into a separate bundle, resulting in multiple bundles of data. In other words, the Iterator extracts all the collections from an array, allowing you to process the elements in each collection individually. On the other hand, the Array Aggregator does the opposite. It converts multiple bundles of data into a single array containing collections of specified items. Simply put, the Array Aggregator returns one bundle of data with multiple collections, each corresponding to a bundle generated by the module whose output you wish to aggregate. In this video, I will demonstrate when and how to use an iterator and what to do with the output. Here, I've created a sample JSON string and then parsed it to return an array. Let me first explain the data structure of the JSON. As you see, I have a single item here called order details, which is an array of the type collection containing two items. The first item, customer, is also a collection containing the items name, email, and phone, each of which is of type text. Similarly, the second item, product, is a collection of three items, name, size, and quantity. Going back now, to create an array, I've added two items here, each of which is a collection. I'm going to refer to these as parent collections. Each parent collection further contains these two child collections, and each child collection comprises some items with sample data. Okay, enough said. Now let's run this scenario once. As you can see, the createJSON module outputs the sample data as a JSON string. This output is mapped in the parseJSON module, which parses the JSON string to return the array as per the predefined data structure. You can see here that orderDetails is an array containing the two parent collections, each of which contains a child collection comprised of their respective items and their values. Now let's assume that we want to send an email to every customer with details of the product purchased. To do that, we need to iterate this array to extract each parent collection as a separate bundle of data. Therefore, in the iterator module, I've mapped the array order details. You will notice that an item will always contain the square brackets if it is an array. Now let's look at the output of the iterator. The parent collections are available as two separate bundles of data, each containing the child collections. Moving on to the email module, the items from the child collections are mapped right here to compose the email which is to be sent to every customer. Looking at the output, you can see that two operations took place to process the two bundles, thereby sending separate emails to both customers. That was made possible only by the iterator. It's important to remember that an iterator can only be used to iterate an array. Additionally, to extract items from a nested array, multiple iterators need to be used. We'll move on to the array aggregator in the next video. See you there.